I'm not really a believer of the supernatural, but what I am a believer of is the paranormal. And now what I mean when I mean paranormal, it's just like something that happened that you can't really explain and it's definitely not normal. My first encounter with a paranormal experience was something I didn't even know was a paranormal experience until I was a lot older. So when I was a kid, what happened was I was going to bed and in my closet I had Lincoln Logs. Dang, these embers getting on my shirt. These Lincoln Logs were in a box that were like this. They're like circular and big, right? And then I had a stack of two of them. These were stacked on top of each other. And I remember while going to bed one night that I heard a loud crash, and it was very audibly the Lincoln Logs. If you guys never played with Lincoln Logs, you would understand. They have a very distinct sound. So they all crashed and fell, and I was like, that's weird. And I fell asleep, and I remember waking up in the morning and the Lincoln Logs on top of that other box of Lincoln Logs fell over, which should be physically impossible, but it happened. That was my first paranormal experience, and I never even knew it was paranormal until I was a lot older, and I was like, holy crap. Like, even at the time, that made zero sense to me, but I understood that, dude, it was crazy. And my next paranormal experience was actually last year during quarantine.
Whoa, oh, this thing is banging.
Here, let me get a different angle. And so this happened last year. One day I was watching, this is embarrassing to say, but I was watching new Fortnite videos from Noah's Noah. I was on the couch just chilling, and then I heard a crash in the basement. And then I heard loud thuds running up the stairs. At first I thought it was my dog, but then I realized both my dogs were with my mom this week and I was completely alone. I freaked out. I grabbed the fire extinguisher and ran straight to my room. And for 20 minutes I contemplated calling the cops, but I was like, man, I shouldn't. But then I realized, like, oh, this is my life at stake. I should like call them. I called them, and by the way, this was my first time I ever called the police. That's a big reason why I was so hesitant to do it, because I've never called the police before in my entire life based off of like actually needing the police. And so I called them. They showed up with three cop cars. They searched the entire house, and there was nothing in there. And there was no sign of entry, or everything in the house was locked up. And now 2 weeks later, I was already paranoid as crap because I thought I was just crazy or something. Being paranoid and then more weird sounds happening is not a good combination. Another door slammed shut, and then I heard footsteps on the same floor that I was in. And then again, I ran upstairs and contemplated calling the cops, and I was like, oh, what if I'm imagining it? What if this is nothing? I called my mom and was like, what do you think I should do? I was so scared. This was the time before I owned a gun, knives, I owned a tomahawk, I owned like five axes. I was like pretty scared and defenseless. I called my mom, she's like, you should just call the police. Called the police, 10 cop cars showed up at my house, and they all searched. And it was really embarrassing. There's no signs of anything. They questioned me like I was retarded. It was such a crazy experience because I've never called the police before. I didn't want to call the police. And I was trying to rationalize it. I was like, okay, maybe there's a squatter in the house. And there isn't. But I was just trying so hard to rationalize. But man, I really can't explain those noises that happened in the house that night. They were very unexplainable noises. They were so distinct that you couldn't mistake it for anything else. Now this next story, this happened this year actually while hiking. My friend and I were on this trail. It was about, the trail's probably 6 miles long, and we went off trail, we were on trail, we were like doing a mixture of stuff, we were exploring the waterfalls. By the end we got to this trail, there's an abandoned mill. We started talking about some crap, supernatural stuff specifically. He was like, yo, do you believe in like skinwalkers and wendigos? And then right as I was about to answer him, and this is like in the middle of nowhere by the way, all of the sudden we hear these thuds on the ground running towards us and this guttural growl. It was a big dog, but at the time we didn't know that because we couldn't see anything. The only light there was the light emitting from these two vending machines at this abandoned mill. Because the abandoned mill was like a historic site. You know, I got all big like this and I was screaming. My throat was so hoarse after it. It was just one of the weirdest experiences ever. Because then this happened. A car came out of nowhere, picked these two dogs up, and then drove off into nowhere. We had to walk a mile through the woods to get to a nearest road. Maybe there was a road, unmarked dirt road or something. It was very creepy that it happened because it was just so unexplainable. We just could not explain it. And then the entire walk back was insanely weird because we're like, yo, like, what if something happens again? And now I have this rule not to talk about supernatural things in the woods because, you know, I don't want to ever deal with that again. Last but not least, this also happened this year. This isn't really just paranormal, but it's creepy. My sister and I were on our long walk. This walk is maybe like 4 or 5 miles long. There's this abandoned house and it's very clearly abandoned. The lawn isn't kept, the shed is in shambles, the house is falling apart, the windows are broken. We decided one day we're gonna go up to the house and look at it and look inside of these broken windows because we're like, why not? It's so close to the road, let's just do it. I get up close up to the window. There's just new furnishing in the entire house. It looks newly painted. There's furnishing like a family lives there. The thing is, there's never been a car out front. We're doing this walk almost every single day. Like after a minute of looking there, I hear a huge slam. I ran away so fast. I didn't want to see what was going on. I ran to the road and I was like, Zoe, this just happened. And she didn't believe me, but it happened. Very weird experience, but hey, there might have been somebody in that house. But yeah, guys, thanks so much for listening to me talk about paranormal stories. This seems like the perfect time of year to capitalize on creepy stuff. I don't celebrate Halloween. It's a dumb holiday. I don't know why anybody would celebrate it. It's definitely fun getting to share these creepy stories with other people because nobody ever asked you. It's something you gotta bring up. There's some crazy stuff out there. I definitely want you guys to talk about any either supernatural or paranormal experiences you've ever had, just experiences you can't explain. Any of them is interesting. Like, I love hearing them. So thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.